Understanding the behavior of large complex models can be difficult due to their complexity. Model Slicer helps reduce the complexity of analyzing such large models by highlighting the areas of interest and allowing the user to generate smaller standalone models. In this video, we will give a basic introduction about common Model Slicer workflows. We will then see how Simulink Test Manager uses Model Slicer to debug a failing test. Model Slicer can be used as a magnifying glass to zoom into interesting parts of a model. Given a block of interest, if you want to know where its values are coming from, you can add it as a starting point and highlight its upstream dependencies. Similarly, if you want to know what other parts of the model does this block affect, you can change the direction of dependency propagation and highlight the downstream dependencies. Model Slicer can also be used during a model simulation. At every time step, you can observe how signal values are propagated through the model. Do you want to create a standalone model for the highlighted blocks? Just click on Generate Slice and a new model will be created in a flash. If you are using System Composer to create architecture models for designing complex systems, you can still use Model Slicer like before to analyze the dependencies. Model Slicer has been integrated with products like Simulink Design Verifier and Simulink Test Manager to provide the user with debugging capabilities. An important workflow today is to compare the output of a model simulation against the output of generated code. This is mandated by standards such as ISO 26262. Simulink Test Manager helps automate such testing by creating equivalence tests to compare outputs from two different simulation modes. Here, we have an equivalence test for a model which compares the output of a normal simulation against a software-in-the-loop simulation. Upon running the test, we can observe a failure in the signal airflow calc 2. This error implies that there is a numerical inconsistency between the model and generated code. Model Slicer's dependency highlighting capabilities can help figure out the source of this inconsistency. You can click on Debug, followed by the Debug using Slicer button to enter Model Slicer debugging mode. Model Slicer enables us to show a refined highlight at the time step when the failure is observed. Model Slicer highlights any difference in values across the two simulations when they diverge. The source of the mismatch can be identified using port value labels and Model Slicer highlighting. In this example, we can see that the failure in Airflow Calc 2 traces back to the MATLAB function block. After addressing the issue in the MATLAB function block, we can rerun the test to ensure that the signal passes. In conclusion, Model Slicer can be used to explore and isolate troubling behavior in complex systems. For more information on Model Slicer and its recent developments, please refer to the documentation linked below.